coming back. Ain't nothing wrong with that. So tell me that, tell me that. Tell me I'm the best I am. I be feeling like yes I am, I am. You know I'm the best I am. Be a fool to not take. All right, good morning everybody. So today we're going to show a video shooting wood therapy. We're going to show with my friend Ashley. She had surgery in March and it's May, so she's about 6 weeks post-op. She had a tummy tuck and lipo 360 and a fat transfer. She's been getting her lymphatic drainage massages 3 times a week like clockwork, and today we're going to start wood therapy. Okay, Ashley. This is my friend Ashley, everybody.
Hi.
She is so awesome. This is like one of my really good friends who I collab with all the time. She's letting us record her second wood therapy session today. So we're just going to talk to Ashley about her post-surgery care. She's a really good advocate for taking care of herself post-surgery. And we just want to talk about this. So first of all, Ashley, tell us what you got done and where you went to get it done.
Okay, so my second round, I actually went to Dominican Republic in Santo Domingo and had a tummy tuck revision. I had arm lipo and a BBL. And I also had chin lipo and thigh lipo.
Okay, and you went where again?
I went to Dominican Republic, Santo Domingo, and my doctor was, they call him Dr. King, or also Dr. Cabral.
Okay, we'll call him Dr. King, that's fine. So you did your research, right?
Yes, yes,
you
yes.
did not go into this eyes closed, everybody.
No.
You gotta do your research. So Dr. King, he gave you good reviews, he made you feel good, made you feel safe.
Yes.
And look how flat her stomach is, guys. Like, this is awesome. So what we're doing as far as wood therapy right now, we're just breaking up this superficial fat right here, and then we're gonna push it through the lymphatic system. So this is just contouring. Wood therapy is good. You're about 6 weeks in, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And how are you feeling? Does this hurt?
No.
Okay, it
feels good.
Okay, it feels good. Wood therapy is not supposed to be like painful, guys. I hear a lot of people out there who are doing too much pressure. It's to the superficial layer. You don't have to press super hard. Let these wood pieces do the work for you. So I'm not pushing super hard. I'm letting it roll along her sides here to kind of contour the sides. At one point we'll probably even put her on her side because she really cares about that hourglass figure coming in. So this is just an easy rolling, guys. It should not be painful. So tell us, Ashley, after surgery, what are some common feelings to have as far as feeling pain or comfort level or things like that? Kind of talk to us about that.
So it is very common, of course, to feel a little discomfort after surgery. You just had a major surgery, and it's very traumatic to the body. So one of the things that I research and make sure of is that I have good after surgery care. So I set up my aftercare surgery with our lady here right even before surgery.
Yes, that's important, you guys. Call me if you're in the Cleveland area. I'm in Beachwood, so I'm in the area, Cleveland area. Call me before your surgery or whatever city you're in. Schedule your massages before surgery, guys. That's a big thing. And Ashley has learned her lesson with that. So she knew to call, and she scheduled a whole month. She scheduled her first 12 massages with me, 3 a week for 4 weeks, guys. That's what we're talking about.
And that helps so much. I can't tell you how much of a relief it is after I get my massage. I feel like I'm able to move better. My mobility is better. I'm not as swollen. It just helps all around with your figure coming in.
Absolutely. And just really removing that fluid, because the fluid is what makes you feel so uncomfortable. And that's the part that people don't take into account, is that the fluid in your back is making you stiff. The fluid can give you a burning sensation sometimes. And removing that fluid naturally through the lymphatic system is your best bet. So tell us a little bit about your diet after surgery, Ashley. When you were still in the DR, what did they have you eating or drinking?
Good question. So they're very big on fluids. I was drinking up towards a gallon of water a day to help move the fluid through the lymphatic system. I also had a diet high in protein. Protein is the building block for repairing the muscles and such. So it's high in protein, lots of vegetables. And they even gave me smoothies. We did a lot of vegetable smoothies, fruit smoothies, and beets. Beets was really good just to get my hemo back up.
Yes, beets, because you had a problem with your hemo, right?
I did. As much as I worked towards getting a high hemo before surgery, which I was 13.9, after surgery I went down to 8. So it's very important that you build your hemo up before surgery, and then afterwards continue to build and take your supplements to maintain.
Yep, so beets is awesome. It's gross. It's not that tasty, but right. You guys, if you've heard of the ABC juice, the apple, beets, and carrots, mm-hmm. That's really good. I have a client who put turmeric and lemon and ginger mm-hmm. in her ABC juice just to pump it up. And that's something that I feel like I want to try mm-hmm. as far as juicing goes. So yes, you want to keep your hemo up, keep that blood level up, low mm-hmm. iron. You do not want to be dealing with that, ladies, when you're on the table. It's dangerous.
It's very dangerous. And it affects the way you feel. You know, you're lightheaded, you're dizzy, you're lethargic, no energy. You feel like you're going to faint almost. So you have to make sure you keep your hemo up.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So as far as this tool goes here, really contouring, giving you almost that ab look. Like she got a six pack, guys. How does this one feel?
It feels good. Yep. I mean, before I ever had wood therapy, I was worried about it would hurt, but it doesn't hurt at all.
Yep, because there are misconceptions that wood therapy is supposed to hurt. There are people out there who are applying too much pressure, but you're just supposed to let these wood tools roll loosely in your fingers and just attack this superficial fat, get those muscles plumped and toned, and coming to the surface, guys. Mm-hmm. So,
and as Cameron said, this is my second session. In the first session, I mean afterwards, I noticed a difference right away.
Yeah,
I mean, my sides are starting to come in a lot.
So. Yes, it's mm-hmm. amazing. So this tool right here is really gonna drain what we just did. She's getting a real flat look in the front. Like I said, today we'll probably turn her on her sides just to really contour those sides real good, and then we'll do her back. Mm-hmm. So here at Massage by Camry, I call this a 360 snatch. Mm-hmm. It's basically just all around the torso, getting that waist to really contour. So wood therapy is not something, it's not the same as cavitation. Cavitation is when you still have superficial fat, guys. And again, cavitation only works on fat. It does not work on fluid. So if you just had surgery and you're getting cavitation too soon, mm-hmm. it is not going to be effective and you are wasting your money. Mm-hmm. If somebody is using the infrared light with the skin tightening, okay, maybe. But again, you might as well just wait until the fluid's gone to tighten the skin, because mm-hmm. after you use it, if the fluid is still building up, if you're still within those first eight weeks, then you tighten the skin, but then the fluid is going to stretch it right back out. Okay. So wait to get cavitation until you're 8 weeks post-op, guys. That's the way you get the best results. Mm-hmm. As well as 6 weeks, you want to start doing a little workout, mm-hmm. and you're only feeding that fat for the first 6 weeks as well. After 6 weeks, then once you feel healthy and you feel good, your energy has come back, then you want to start your diet regimen, guys, because you mm-hmm. just got this awesome body. You just spent all this money to get this done. So diet and exercise should not be a question. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. these body sculpting techniques go along with diet and exercise. This is not just standalone. You should not just be getting cavitation and then going to McDonald's getting two double cheeseburgers with Big Mac sauce, okay? No. Cavitation is to couple with diet and exercise. Wood therapy is a part of your body sculpting regimen, and you should probably do it weekly. Mm-hmm. So right now with Ashley, because she's about 6 weeks post-op, we're still doing one lymphatic massage a week, mm-hmm. but then we're doing the wood therapy coupling with that, because she's coming in twice a week right now because she's in her second month. Mm-hmm. And then for her third month, our plan is to do wood therapy once a week just mm-hmm. to keep her super snatched because it's about to be summer and yes. we want these MILFs to be out here looking good.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right.
Because yes, right. this is a mother of three. Okay. Yes. Believe it or not.
Yes. I highly recommend Camry. I had my first round with Camry also, and she did my aftercare, which I set up before my surgery. Mm-hmm. She's prompt, she's on time, she really cares. Not only is she doing a procedure on you, but she's also educating you, which is super important. So I highly recommend her. You'll get all your time. I know sometimes therapists will kind of cut corners. You don't have to worry about that with Camry. She's strictly doing the right thing, very professional and ethical, so I highly recommend her.
Thank you, Ashley. Yes, I do care. I'm actually obsessed with this. Mm-hmm. And people like Ashley. She's my favorite kind of client, even mm-hmm. though she's my friend too. Mm-hmm. Because she shows up. You know, she wants good results. So she's going to put in the work. And all you have to do is show up for me, guys. And yep. if you are here, then I'm going to make it work. I'm going to give you what you need. I'm mm-hmm. not going to give you a service that you don't need. If it's too soon for cavitation, I'm going to tell you.
Yes.
If you're not a candidate for wood therapy, I'm going to tell you.
Mm-hmm.
We've done the tape method to bring in yes. Ashley's little dog ears a little bit that she mm-hmm. had in the beginning. And we'll probably tape one more time. But honestly, they're gone.
Oh, yeah. That
yeah,
works.
We taped like twice. And yes. I did show a video on that on my Instagram, taping Ashley. And her little dog ears are like gone. Like the yeah. skin has retracted.
Absolutely.
Yeah. The tape method is awesome. Of course, I'll show videos on that
mm-hmm.
Coming soon. And I'll probably post the one that I took of taping Ashley too. So,
and Ms. Camry also has a lot of supplies that you need after surgery, too.
True. Good thinking, Ashley. See, I don't even know what to say. So, yes, the Certified Body, that is the brand. That is the product brand that we have. So, we have waist trainers. We have two different types of fajas. Our fajas are very durable, along with our waist trainers, very durable. They're very effective. Mm-hmm. So they're crotchless. Mm-hmm. They snap and zip, and they have adjustable straps.
Mm-hmm.
So those fajas, if you're especially in the Cleveland area where you want to come try one on, mm-hmm. we schedule fittings. They're $15. And if you purchase, then you get that $15 off. Or if you're just buying online, then that's fine too, because mm-hmm. we have a size chart online. So you just kind of look at your inches and see which one you should get. So yes, we sell fajas. We usually have foams and boards. I try to have lymphatic drops,
mm-hmm.
which do work.
Yes.
I have people ask me all the time, are lymphatic drops worth it?
Mm-hmm.
The thing with lymphatic drops is you want it to be a natural supplement. If it's ginger in there, then that's definitely going to be really effective in helping you go to the bathroom. Taking a laxative or a water pill, only if prescribed by the doctor, guys. Don't just go take a laxative if you're not going to the bathroom. You want to use natural remedies. So beet juice, prune juice,
mm-hmm.
or the lymphatic drops, which are natural herbal mm-hmm. supplements. You want to go natural because this is your body trying to heal.
Mm-hmm.
Only use a laxative or a water pill if your doctor prescribed it after surgery. Sometimes I hear people taking those and it doesn't always work out.
Yeah.
It's not always a pretty sight.
Absolutely.
And then too, Ashley learned her lesson about doing a detox tea too soon.
Yes.
Going through this process. You should detoxing right after surgery is not a good idea. Talk about that, Ashley.
Yes.
That was funny.
Yes. So I would say wait until you're healed and you're
yep.
up and mobile before you do any sort of detox.
Mm-hmm.
Six weeks. The biggest thing is the dehydration. You're already dehydrated.
Yep.
From having surgery, your fluids are depleted. And so on top of the detox, pulling water from your system, you will be severely dehydrated.
Yeah.
And it's not a good picture.
Yeah, because I sell detox tea too, but I do not suggest it for post-surgery care. The first 6 weeks, you're trying to rehydrate your
mm-hmm.
body. You're not trying to push things out. Wow, mm-hmm. this is like really looking good. Like skin tightening, you're going to see a big difference after.
Awesome.
Yeah,
awesome.
This is like the skin tightening tool. And then we're going to do a little cupping after this. I'm going to move her on her sides. But yes, so no, you don't want to do any detox teas. You
mm-hmm.
don't want to do any detoxes, guys. If something says detox run,
yeah.
as long as if it says lymphatic cleanse, okay, that's,
mm-hmm.
you know, that's what you want to do. But because you're focusing on clearing out your lymphatic system. But no, if it's a detox tea or something for weight loss right now, it's like, no, no. Wait 6 weeks. Give your body a break. You know, you just did this extremely, as far as liposuction or a tummy tuck goes, like Ashley said, traumatic to the body. You know, it's, you can have beautiful results, but your body at first is like, what did you just do to me?
Yeah.
So you don't want to go right in trying to still lose weight the first 6 weeks.
Because you'll lose the fat. You have to feed the fat.
Yeah.
The fat is new to the home that it's at. So for example, like they took the fat from my various places and put it in my behind.
Mm-hmm.
And you want to feed that fat. It's new. You don't want to lose it. So you want to eat a good high protein type of regimen of food to continue to feed that fat so it doesn't die, so it does survive.
Exactly. So the first 6 weeks, you're not focusing on losing weight, guys. You're focusing on removing that fluid, keeping good circulation, hydrating, getting your blood levels back up, your hemo back up, and you're trying to feed that fat.
That's
you're trying to...
It's like the morning time, don't wanna wake up, I just wanna stay in bed.